Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. So over the last few tutorials, we were learning about the Android Studio basics. We have covered almost everything that can be used for the better understanding of how to make an Android app. So we have discussed about the text view button, toggle button, blah blah blah, many of the things over here. And finally, we have discussed about the one of the best and the most useful content, which is web view. Now we have all over with almost everything. So today I will show you how to use or how to add a custom icon into your Android app, and finally how to compile that Android app. So in the previous videos, we have seen how to run the Android app in a live device. So today I will show you how to generate the APK for the Android app, and you can able to pass that APK through your social medias and other things, and you can share with your friends and likewise. So including that, and the next thing I will be showing you that is how to add a custom icon for your Android application. So we have the big map folder under the rest folder, and we have seen here is the icon by default Android Studio offer into our Android application. So we are going to change the icon into something different. So the first thing is going to be changing the icon. So I'm going to remove everything over here. First, I'm going to use the famous photo editing tool, which is Photoshop, for creating an icon. So I'm opening my Photoshop. We have to create a new square type layout once the Photoshop is turned on. For the better experience, we have to set the resolution for that 1536, that is going to be 1536 as the pixel. In pixel ratio, it is 1:1. So we have to go to the file first of all. If you don't have the Photoshop, you can use any online image editor. If you have Windows, then you can use the MS Paint itself. Then let me show you. So if I have Windows XP, so MS Paint over here. So once you are in the MS Paint, all you have to do is press Ctrl E, which will pop up the image properties window, and all you have to do is simply change the width and height into 1536 in both cases. Okay, so press the OK. Now you will get a square type window. Okay, so here it is. Now I always suggest going with something transparent background that make little more sense for your Android application, and it will give you a better experience for your users. So likewise, then you have to save it as PNG or JPG or whatever else you want. Now let's move on to the Photoshop. Now we have the Photoshop going a little bit higher level. I'm going to change it into okay. Now we have a blank screen. I'm going to add something like a material icon. For that, I'm going to add, so you can customize your icon as the way you want, and I'm just going to show you just an example. So I'm going to use a custom shape from the Photoshop. We have this music icon. I'm just going to drag it into here. Now we have something just example logo. So what we are going to do is that once you have completed editing your logo, you have to save it, and while saving, you have to save it as PNG or JPEG format. So I'm going to save it as PNG for the better experience, and I'm going to save it in the desktop with name app icon. You can give anything as you wish. Click on the save. Now I'm closing the Photoshop. Now going to the Google Chrome, and I'm searching for make app icon. Okay, so here we go. Now go to the website called make app icon, and I will be adding all the links below this video so you can able to go through that easily. Okay, so we have the website here. So by the way, the reason why I'm using this website is just because this website can able to increase the size of your image into the maximum, and the best quality can be utilized with this website. And also this website can provide icon size for the each kind of or each device's type and each display sizes. So I'm going to choose the file. Now I'm browsing my icon created in the Photoshop. Now it's baking. We just have to wait a couple seconds. Okay, now it's success, and now we have to type the email address to receive that file. I'm going to uncheck this. So you can see here is the example how it looked like inside the Android device. So we have the preview over here. I'm going to click on the sale or download or whatever else. Now I'm going to my mail. Okay, so we have the message from the Make My App. Now we have to download the file, attach it with this file. So apk.zip, I'm going to download it. So once the file is downloaded, you have to open that, which will be a zip file. So you have to use WinRAR to open this zip file. Now you can see here is the Android, iMessenger, iOS, and something like that. So all you have to do is you have to simply extract it into the desktop. I'm going to make a folder app, and here we go. Now exit, and finally we have to close the Chrome browser. Now we have the folder app, and inside that we have the Android folder. So you have seen here is the Play Store icon and other almost 6 or 7 folders. You have to just select all and copy, and now move to the Android Studio. Now you have to paste it under the we have to just go to the location. So right click on somewhere else over here. I'm just going to right click on the rest folder, Train Explorer, and we have to paste it here. So paste it. Now you have to replace these things. Okay, so now let's move on to the Android Studio back again. Now when I'm moving, you can see it automatically changed the icon into something like this. Finally, we have changed the app icon. What's next is that we have to build the application as a APK file. So we have to click on the build. From the top, you have to move to the build APK. So we have the two different options. We can able to generate the signed APK, or we can able to build the application without a signed license APK. So we are going to choose the first one, which is always a pretty much decent and fastest method. So the second one required the to fill up a license in order to just upload your application into the Google Play Store, which we will be uploading as soon as the tutorial get ended up. Now let's move and select the build APK, and now you can see it is loading and it's building the APK. And once it is completed, we can see there will be a pop-up message which shows that APK has been built and it's ready. Okay, so now we have seen, we have the build APK message. Now APK is generated successfully. Now we have to click on the show in Explorer, which will pop up the Explorer window, which shows that app debug. So this is a debug version of this Android app, which is around 3.72 megabytes. I don't know why it's too much size, but anyway, now we have to copy this into our Android app, and we will be able to see the Android app with a custom icon. And you can able to share this APK with your friends so that the friends can able to use your application. And now we are going to minimize it. So we have completed almost everything in the basics of the Android Studio. Now we are going to move a little bit advanced level of Android programming. So in order to get into the advanced level, you have to use some kind of different kind of activities files. So at the beginning of the Android app development, I have shown you guys that using empty activity. So we are going to use something different in the next, from the next tutorial onwards. So we are going to close this project now from here, and I will be adding all the project and different tutorial section as in my website, which is techsotro.com, available description in this video. So in order to end up a project, you have to go to the file and click on the close project. Hope you know that idea. Okay, anyway, now we have that. So today we have almost completed everything, and from the next tutorial itself, we'll be starting something a little bit advanced. And I hope you guys got the idea, and if you have any kind of doubts, you can probably comment below this video, and you can able to clear all your doubts, and I will be answering all your questions as fast as possible. Stay tuned. In the meantime, you can check my website techsotro.com for any kind of latest updates, and there are plenty of tutorials available in my channel, so go and check it. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.